I really didn't want to do it.
Time and the world swallows events.
And one day the world is going to swallow us up. But I like to think we're doing something good with what we're given.
And I read it and I just thought, this is such a fantastic script. The sort of detail and the sense of mounting anxiety I had reading it, you know, as the writing sort of folds you into this kind of dilemma. I mean, it's a sort of moral thriller, I suppose is what it is. And it just every single aspect of that situation is dealt with. With great sort of accuracy and clarity. And apart from that, it's a fantastic role.
We got to keep this tight. We're all in it. The whole force, mate.
No, I just thought, well, with rather a heavy heart, I phoned up my American agent and said, it's one of the best scripts I've ever read. I'm going to do it.
High praise from veteran film and television actor Tom Wilkinson for Joel Edgerton's screenplay for Felony. Wilkinson also stars beside Edgerton, Jai Courtney and Melissa George in this taut police drama, directed by Matt Saville. Saville, who also worked for a number of years with Edgerton on the screenplay, is a truly individual talent. His previous big screen outings, Roy Holst's Alive and The Brilliant Noise, alongside some really interesting TV work, including the seminal Cloud Street, is a truly individual and talented screen director. The story of Felony puts three generations of policemen on that thin blue line. I spoke with Saville and Edgerton.
For me, right from the credit sequence, from the graphics in the credit sequence, you're telling the audience you're going to cross that thin blue line.
Hey!
You're going to go from law and order into, not anarchy, but you're going to cross the line. Joel, you wrote this. What was the attraction to that, crossing that line?
Well, you know, on one hand, you invite the audience into what they think is going to be like a police procedural kind of, you know, police drama. And then it becomes an internal affairs sort of struggle. But then beyond that, it becomes an internal moral struggle with a lot of differing opinions about the same incident. You know, I really love this, and I've read the screenplay for Unforgiven, and you've got all these characters that all have a relationship to the question of taking a person's life. And to me, this was one of those things where you get the delectable ability to have all these characters surrounding the one incident who have an opinion about crime and the punishment that fits the crime, guilt, and then the responsibility of guilt, and where does forgiveness lie and the ability to rejoin the human race, all within this kind of, you know, piece of entertainment.
Matt, you worked with Joel on this script for a number of years. Was that what drew you into it?
Every project that I've worked on has one thing in common, which is that I respond to, which is just, I think honesty is the best word for it. There's just an honesty to Joel's writing that you don't have to suspend disbelief. You don't, it's all terrifyingly plausible. I love investigating stories that, you know, flying through the clouds, you know, the murk. And thinking about things in not binary terms, you know, because that's where complexity is. And I'm sometimes more interested in the questions than the answers. You know.
As Joel said, this is it's a thriller. It's a looks like a police procedural, but it doesn't play like a standard police procedural.
Well, it's not a mystery. You know, there's no mystery there. There's nothing. There's no crime to solve. We know who.
Yeah.
We know who did what.
So what are the challenges for you as director, though, to take something that's an internal moral conversation, a dilemma, it's a very tight, contained world. How do you take what feels like a small story and turn it into something that's going to play on the big screen?
I actually find plot-driven dramas more challenging because you've got a crowd in all of this event. What I'm more interested in pursuing is the emotional landscape. And so if you get all the, you know, get as much plot out of the way as you can, it leaves you a lot of real estate to go and explore these far more for interesting emotional territories, which for me, are easier to direct.
I might not seem like a good person, but I have to be a good mother. I think what I said last night is right. And I hate myself for saying it. It's horrible. But you've done this to me. You made me this.
Sound design in this is absolutely fantastic, as is the score. Was that delivered after the film, or were you considering that before and during?
I do think about, you know, what the sonic landscape would be a little bit. When I made Noise, it was because, you know, the soundscape of that film was so indelibly part of the, you know, the plot, as it were, that we had to kind of consider that a little bit more carefully before, you know, during the shoot. This one, not so much. It was, you know, get to a rough cut stage at least, and then start thinking about soundscapes. And the score was written by my wife, Bryony. I think she's done a lovely job with it.
Mm. Yeah, incredible. That's one of the great treats for me, because, you know, sound is not something that's really big on my mind. You know, it's all story, character, and coming to watch the finished product, or even the early cuts of the film, and you started to hear the thing, realizing just how much I remind myself that sound and music are just as important to a film as what you're watching.
Also the lack of sound. I mean, there's a lot of scenes where, you know, it's a film that's about, it's a paranoid thriller in a sense. So it's about watching, and it's about having a sense of being watched. You know, that Malcolm always feels as though he's being scrutinised.
Emergency. I'm on Epsom Road. A boy has hit his head and he's not moving.
So the absence of sound sometimes can be, you know, more potent.
Felony, though it falls on occasion to the mellow side of its drama, is a beautifully crafted and wonderfully performed piece of cinema, well worth catching on the big screen. This has been Pete Castaldi. Till next time.